Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreyasa Vijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 15th of June. Indian Army pays homage to soldiers killed in Galwan Valley clash with Chinese troops on first anniversary. Former judge alleges Pakistan spy agency ISI meddles in judiciary to manipulate cases. And UN readies for more displaced Afghans after withdrawal of foreign troops. And now for all the details. The Indian Army on Tuesday paid homage to soldiers who died during the violent face-off with Chinese troops in Galwan Valley near the line of actual control in India's northern Ladakh region a year ago. 20 Indian soldiers were killed on the intervening night of June 15, 16, 2020 in the Galwan Valley.
On the first anniversary of the violent clash between the armies of India and China in the Galwan Valley near the line of actual control LAC in eastern Ladakh, Indian Army on Tuesday paid homage to the soldiers killed in the face-off. Senior Indian Army official Major General Akash Kaushik of the Fire and Fury Corps also laid a wreath at the Leh War Memorial. A statement issued by the PRO Defence said the nation will remain eternally grateful to these gallant soldiers who fought in the most difficult high-altitude terrain and made the supreme sacrifice in service of the nation. It was the first time in more than 40 years that lives are lost in the border along the line of actual control. Meanwhile, a year after the incident, the Indian Defence Forces have strengthened its deployments in Ladakh as well as the entire LSC, as it has now deployed an additional strike corps to tackle the China border.
Today, the Indian military has carried out rapid mobilization, large-scale deployment along the LSC, and has enhanced its defence preparedness. With the Chinese dragging their feet on disengagement from various areas, the situation, though calm, remains tense.
Meanwhile, 4 months after India and China disengaged from the most contentious Pangong Lake area in Ladakh and 2 months after Corps commander-level talks failed to make headway on pullback of troops from other regions of eastern Ladakh, China reportedly has suggested negotiations at the level of division commanders. However, disengagement still exists despite several rounds of talks since last year. The Corps commander-level talks on April 9 made no progress.
A former judge of the Islamabad High Court has alleged that Pakistan spy agency ISI's Director General Faiz Hamid and other military officers visited his residence to try and manipulate case proceedings back in 2018. Reports suggest that two of these cases pertain to the conviction of ousted Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif in corruption cases and acquittal of CEO of a news channel.
Former judge of the Islamabad High Court, Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui, has alleged that Pakistan's Inter-Services Intelligence or ISI Director General Lieutenant General Faiz Hamid and other military officers visited his residence to try and manipulate case proceedings back in 2018. Two of these cases pertain to the conviction of ousted Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif in corruption cases and the acquittal of the founder and CEO of Bol News Channel in 2018. Reports suggest Siddiqui made the accusations in a reply to the Supreme Court earlier this month during a hearing against his removal from office in 2018. Salahuddin Ahmed, president of the Sindh High Court Bar Association, tweeted pictures of the former judge's reply. Siddiqui was removed from office after he delivered a speech to a bar association where he had accused security agencies of meddling in judicial affairs. The spy agency, ISI, which primarily consists of serving military officers, has long been accused of interfering in judicial matters for favorable verdicts and influencing media houses to shape public opinion. The Pakistan government in the latest has denied the allegations leveled by Siddiqui, terming them baseless and misleading.
Moving on, all line department employees in illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan have continued to protest to raise their demands of equal pay and allowances at par with other government employees in Pakistan. They blamed discrimination and claimed the authorities have kept on delaying the process for the past several years. A sit-in was recently held outside the Chief Minister's house by all line department employees in Gilgit-Baltistan as their protest to demand equal pay and allowances have continued. The protesters demanded equal pay at par with their counterparts in Pakistan, including technical, upgradation and timescale allowances. They also demanded that the government comply with their three demands, failing which they would surround the assembly in the illegally occupied region. The protesters said their charter of demands had been presented to the government for approval and warned regular protest would continue until these demands are complied with. They said it is indeed appalling that people in the illegally occupied region who have served for several years in the government departments still do not have access to equal rights and have to face exploitation.
Violence has been rising in Afghanistan as foreign forces begin withdrawing and efforts to broker a peace settlement between the Afghan government and insurgent Taliban have slowed. United Nations is preparing for a likely further displacement of civilians in Afghanistan after US and international troops leave the country in September.
The United Nations is preparing for a likely further displacement of civilians in Afghanistan after US and international troops leave the country in September, UN Refugee Chief Filippo Grandi said on Monday. There are currently some 2.5 million registered refugees from Afghanistan globally, while another 4.8 million have been displaced within the country, according to the UN Refugee Agency UNHRC, which Grandi heads. After 20 years, the United States has started a withdrawal of its remaining 2,500 troops in Afghanistan and aims to be completely out of the country by September 11. Violence has been rising in Afghanistan as foreign forces begin withdrawing and efforts to broker a peace settlement between the Afghan government and insurgent Taliban have slowed.
And with the withdrawal of the international troops, this is possibly or likely going to become worse, and therefore we are doing contingency planning inside the country for further displacement and in neighboring countries in case people might cross borders. However, what is also very important to note is that there are talks between the Taliban and the government, and it is important that the international community supports these talks so that they can get to a positive conclusion.
Meanwhile, U.S. President Joe Biden at a press conference after the NATO Leaders Summit in Brussels on Monday said the alliance will continue its support to Afghans after the withdrawal of international troops from the country. NATO leaders, in a statement issued from the Brussels summit, affirmed their commitment to continue to stand with Afghanistan, its people and its institution in promoting security and upholding the hard-won gains of the last 20 years. U.S.-backed Afghan forces toppled the Taliban in late 2001 for refusing to hand over al-Qaeda leader Osama bin Laden after the September 11, 2001 attacks on the United States.
In news from Sri Lanka, the captain of the container ship that caught fire and sank off the west coast of Sri Lanka, causing a major environmental disaster, faced court on Monday after being arrested by Sri Lankan authorities and was later granted bail. The captain was charged under the Marine Pollution Prevention Act, which prohibits the dumping of oil, harmful substances and other pollutants in the ocean and coastal areas.
Tutkalo Vetili, the captain of the container ship that caught fire and sank off the west coast of Sri Lanka, causing a major environmental disaster, faced court on Monday after being arrested by Sri Lankan authorities. Vitaly, the Russian captain, appeared in a Colombo court where he was released on $10,000 bail and was told by the court his overseas travel ban would also be extended. The Singapore-registered MV Express Pearl, carrying 1,486 containers, including 25 tons of nitric acid along with other chemicals and cosmetics, was anchored off the port city of Negombo when a fire erupted on board after an explosion on May 20. The ship, which was only 4 months old, began to sink early on June 2. A salvage crew tried to tow the vessel to deeper water away from the coast, but the attempt was abandoned after the rear of the ship touched the seabed. A special team of the Navy divers have been inspecting the hull of the ship, along with the specialists from the salvage company monitoring for any oil spill. Meanwhile, Sri Lanka is seeking $40 million in damages from the operator of a ship, Express Feeders, that left massive pollution when it caught fire off the country's west coast. Sri Lankan environmentalists have called it the worst marine disaster in country's history. Darshini Lahendapura, head of the state-run Marine Pollution Protection Authority, last week said authorities were still assessing the total damages and the interim claim seeks compensation for expenses from May 20 when the ship caught fire through June 1.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Inoculation drive with the China-donated COVID-19 vaccine Verocell has resumed again in Nepal after being halted last week due to insufficient number of doses. Meanwhile, rights group Amnesty International has called on the international community to increase aid supply to the Himalayan nation as it combats a severe third wave of the pandemic.
After a pause of 3 days, vaccination drive has resumed in Nepal as China started the dispatch of its COVID-19 vaccine Verocell to the Himalayan nation after halting it last week, citing insufficient number of doses. Officials at a COVID-19 operation center started their work earlier from Monday as the vaccines are being loaded onto ice boxes and prepared for dispatch to inoculation centers where they would be administered to the citizens.
खोप केन्द्रमा रहेका भ्याक्सिनेटर त्यसको यो खोप केन्द्रको जुन एउटा व्यवस्थापन टिम छ जनप्रतिनिधिहरू हुन्छ भोलन्टियर टिम छ तिनीहरूले यो खोप लैसकेपछि त्यहाँ जुन 60-देखि 80 वर्ष के 60-देखि 64 वर्ष उमेर समूहका नागरिकहरू र जुन पहिले भेरोसेल लगाएका जुन नागरिकहरू हुनुहुन्छ जो दोस्रो खोप छुटेको छ तिनीहरू र स्वास्थ्य कर्मीहरू लाई पनि हामीले चाहिँ जुन फ्रन्ट लाइनमा बसेका स्वास्थ्य कर्मीहरूलाई पनि लगाउने व्यवस्था गरेका छौँ र त्यसरी
Meanwhile, Amnesty International on Monday called on the international community to increase aid supply as well as vaccines to Nepal as it battles a severe third wave of the pandemic. The rights group also called upon the country's politicians to set aside their differences and take decisive action in the coming weeks in order to save thousands of lives.
A famous heritage crafts village in India's Odisha state has turned into an art camp as everyone is working from home amid the pandemic, adorning walls and doors with murals. Around 150 artisan families which are participating will be provided remuneration for the task and the top 5 best works will be awarded by Lalit Kala Academy, the National Academy of Fine Arts.
In the wake of the coronavirus pandemic, the famous artisan's village in Puri district of India's eastern Odisha state has turned into an art camp as everyone is working from home adorning their walls with vibrant scenes from Hindu epics and folk stories. As many as 150 artisan families in Raghurajpur Heritage Crafts Village are participating in the camp, which is usually held in the state capital Bhubaneswar. But in view of the COVID-19 restrictions, the camp has been taken to their doorstep. As a task, the artisans have been asked to draw murals on the walls, poles and doorsteps of their own homes in exchange for 10,000 rupees or nearly $137 remuneration for each of them.
कोविड के वजह से बहुत लोग ये काम छोड़ के बाहर के काम में भी चले गए हैं तो ये काम में और इंटरेस्ट नहीं रह रहे इसको और बढ़ावा देने के लिए कल्चर डिपार्टमेंट इसको कुछ नया तरीका से बना के इसको लेके आया है जो आर्टिजन को खुशी लग रहा है।
The competition will continue till June 16 and the top 5 best works will be awarded by the Odisha branch of the Lalit Kala Academy, India's National Academy of Fine Arts.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.